Welcome back, my friends, to another episode of Dominions 5. In this Let's Play series, we are playing Early Age Hellline. Let's continue from where we left off. So, if you have been following this Let's Play series, this is going to be a very important turn for us. We will attack Agartha in two provinces around here in this turn. So, we will move these two big armies, one over here, which is a fairly big one, and other one over here. So we will strike Agartha. We could strike Vanheim, we could strike Agartha. It was between those two nations. I think it matches our army, our units better fighting Agartha, because I think their regular army, it's a little bit more weak than Vanheim, which has similar units to us. So we will attack Agartha, but bear in mind, we are in the smack middle of many enemy nations. So we could start a war here and need to defend here, but well, that's Dominions 5. We are not always 100% protected. So we'll try to attack Agartha. We'll see if we can get an advantage fairly quick, so that we don't misplace too much our armies. Even we have here a couple of castles that can should hold up our eastern front fairly well, or at least hold a little bit while we move to defend. We should have a castle down south so that we can also have a place to defend ourselves, but fairly now we don't have any space to expand unless it's expand over an elimination, and with the data that we have now, I think our best option, our best bet, it's clearly Agartha. So we will strike Agartha next turn. Let me just show you the recruitment this turn. In my capital, we'll get our first anger drought next turn, and Heli Dreams and Yuskarls over here. I'm just recruiting an independent commander and a couple of Surf Warriors, the most cheap unit, because I want to start blood hunting in this province, and those guys will help in patrolling the province. Over here, the usual recruitment. One Elkarl and a couple of Uskarls, and over here I will get a scout and an Uskarls. I only have one commander point available, so I will use that to get a scout, because next turn, I think it's next turn, we will get level 2 fortification here. Let me just check quickly. Yes, 1 month remaining, so that's nice. Magic wise, we'll reach construction level 4 next turn. So this turn it's double important turn, because we will attack Agartha and we will finally reach construction level 4, which allow us to build, among other things, the dowsing rod that will help us tremendously with blood hunting. So that's it, and then we will get a couple of levels of alteration, and then I will rethink a little bit our next research. We checked recruitment, we checked magic, moves. I have a couple of moves around here. I have a couple of moves around here. This guy should start down below, first off, because is this guy's going to site search for nature and magic sites, and I want first to clear out around these and then going back for up. I want to start site searching, since I don't have any kind of site searching in nature spells. At least we will site search first on our most defended provinces. Let's check nation overview. Nothing special, nothing that I need to mention that I haven't mentioned until now. So a couple of scouts are moving, the other ones are staying put because they are in good places, and that's about it. I'm not casting any kind of ritual spell, and I'm also not casting not forging any items for now. So nothing to see on nation overview. Let's finish up the turn, because it's going to be a turn full of events. Hope all good. Four commanders doing nothing, it's scouts. We should have here lots of battles. Let's see. So, big news in this, looking at the messages, we were attacked by Van Eyem. I clearly can see that in two provinces, and we attacked Agartha in two provinces. One magical site, and two thrones claimed, construction completed, alteration completed. We got our fortress also built. Let's start with the bad news, of course. Let's see the battles that Van Eyem attacked us. Clearly, we don't have any kind of province defense, so we should lose both provinces. These guys are strong enough just by themselves, so I don't believe that these guys are going to be able to defend from these guys. These guys are not that special, but we also don't have any kind of defense. So let's see what happens in the first battle. Already fleeing with a couple of units, and we should start losing our And we lost our first battle, as was to be expected, and probably we will also lose with this big army. Big for Van Eyem terms, and even ours. We don't need that big armies, but against our small province defense, we won't be able to withstand this attack, and we lose two battles. Let's see our battles against Agartha. Hope that went much more better. Big army, just a couple of province defense. Nothing, I don't think it's going to be a big trouble to us. Our heavy cavalry will smash the enemies. No losses, and we just trashed the province defense. Over here at Lish, and also a battle between Niflheim and Kailaza. And Niflheim won. Of course, with nine giants, just this is a 1,000 plus gold coins army. This army is going to be smashing around Kalaiza all over the place. With these nine giants by themselves, are a force to be reckoned with, and of course they are with friends. I hope Niflheim does not send these guys right now at us, because three wars, I don't think I can manage it. And our second battle at Lish. Let's watch this battle. Also a big army and small province. I think it's just province defense. So again, this should be. Fairly quick, We just lost one Askarl and one Serf Warrior, and we managed to kill three units from Agartha and the province defense. Nice. And a battle between Ktish and Van Eyem, and Ktish won. Why the hell did Van Eyem try to attack us while they are with the war against Ktish? It's difficult for me to understand, but okay. Let me just check the borders. Our next battles against Agartha probably will be a little bit more difficult, has to be expected, because they have armies, and now we just fought province defense. And against Van Eyem, we lost these two, but we can be attacked around here. Even because all of the units of Van Eyem they are stealthy, so I clearly don't know what kind of composition of armies are around here. Agartha, we can see clearly the armies that where they are, but Looking at Vanheim, we cannot. So we need to keep a lookout. But on the first stage, of course, I will need to defend around these two provinces, and probably will shuffle his army around like this so that he can protect our north. I don't see any kind of different strategy possible around here. But as usual, give me a moment. I will set up the moves for this turn, recruitment, because of course we can, if we can hold out a couple of turns, we will have another big army like this ready to lead out from our capital, which can make the difference. Because right now, well, if I knew, I shouldn't have attacked Agartha, but probably if we didn't attack Agartha, Vanheim would also not attack us. But we have a nice province advantage comparing to Vanheim. I don't see any castle that they have. So with these three castles recruiting, we can have a big output of units comparing to Vanheim. Even if we take a couple of losses at the beginning, we can match those armies fairly quickly. Of course, we have to worry about Agartha because we just started a war against them right now. But Vanheim is also have to worry about Ktij to the east. So, well, everybody has to worry about everybody. That's the bottom line in Dominion 5. Guys, give me a moment. Of course, we have reached construction level 5. Sorry, construction level 4. That means that I can start forging dowsing rods, which is good. And I need to think a little bit more about what to research next, because I have just alteration level 2, and I will reach that value fairly quickly. So, it's going to be a little bit. I'm going to have to have a little trouble issuing the orders for this turn. Let me just see. Yeah, we found a magical site. We got the Garden of Bones, one death gem, which is nice because I just lost two provinces, each one with a death site. So at least that compensates somewhat from those two lost provinces. Give me a moment, and I'll be right back. So my friends, what are we going to do this turn? Lot of decisions to do to make. I hope I've made the correct ones. Right here, we'll split this army in two, and one will strike here, and the other one will strike here. I think we have enough troops to do both. So let me just check. Yeah, you the positioning with these guys. Yeah, this guy's going to bless. Yeah. That's okay, and over here it's the same blessing and blessing. Okay, we'll split this army in two. It's a big one, and I think we can take two provinces, so we'll attack those both. I will move my prophet to this throne province over here. I don't still I don't know I want to take it before they build a fortification there, but clearly I don't know how we are going to keep it for ourselves for a while, because against Agartha I had everything planned, but since Vanheim is also attacking us, it's a province that it's going to generate a lot of heat. So let's see how that goes. First, let's strike that province to disrupt any kind of construction that's happening there. For the rest, I'm not going to move against Vanheim just yet. I don't have any kind of big army or army where I can, with confidence, strike out. So I will keep recruiting in my castles, a couple of defenses, one more Bear Tribe Shaman, keep site searching here, a Vanyarl and a couple of Huskarls. This guy's going to, my dwarf is going to move back. This guy's going to move over here, sneaking. Let's see if he can help my prophet army. And in my capital, I will recruit for one more turn, which I have. I will get these guys, a couple of Hellir drinks, and a couple of and the Vanners. And probably next turn, I will move that army up. so that he can or join this castle and counterattack or something like that. So that's what I am going to do. Recruitment wise, I spent all my money around here. I was hoping to start building a lab around here and start making this province a fully autonomous province, but I don't want to spend any kind of money in temples or labs just for now. I want to spend all of the money in troops. So I will move back my two commanders back. One of them is going to get the dowsing rod, because he was going to start blood hunting, and then after building a lab I would equip it, but I'm not going to build a lab in the next couple of turns, so he'll go back. I'm forging a dowsing rod, and then you'll go back around here again and start blood hunting. The other guy was here to build a temple also and the lab, but I'm going to move them back and to keep researching in my capital. Regarding the moves, that's it. Around here, a couple of units site searching, and let me just show you. National review, nothing special. A couple of scouts are moving, others are not, because I don't need to. And I'm forging a Sangain Dowsing Rod to give that extra bonus, extra boost in blood hunting. And the school staff. This item costs 10 death gems, and it's a booster item. It will give +1 to death magic, so that I can, let me just show you in my capital, if I equip this guy with that staff, he will be a level 2 death mage. And with it, I just need my revenant, or to bring more revenants, cast the ritual spell that brings more revenants, or even to forge more school staffs, so that I don't waste any turns of the other guys. So I'm now wasting a turn of my anger rod, which has 17 research points, or you can lead in battle or do awesome things. And now he's forging a school staff. It was he or my hero or my pretender, so it was him that's going to forge the school staff, and then afterwards I will have revenants to do that more tedious work of summoning more units or more units, more revenants, because if we need higher death mages, I need the usual ones. So that's just a quick side note about the school staff. And you are defending, of course, and that's it. Research and hiding and sneaking, nothing among all the important things, nothing special about the national overview. Let's finish up the turn and see what's going to happen in the next turn. Lots of battles. So, alteration, another drone, two magical sites. Well, at least we got good news. Let's see the first battle. We attack the guard at Plotai. Let's see that battle. It's a smallish province defense, so I think we handle this fairly quickly. It's fairly standard battle, and one of our trademarks, we won the battle without taking a single loss. The second battle at Gol Ambrod, let's see if we have the same success. We should, it's just a smallish province defense, and our cavalry is going to trample. They don't trample, but they run over everything, and I think we killed their prophet. Here we just lost one Uskarl. Second battle, we were attacked by Vanheim at Ard. Probably we will lose this province, yes. And again, with their big army, these guys does not stand a chance. So they are going to be overrun fairly. So we lost another province to Vanheim. A battle at Leash, let's see. With a big army, so they should take out this smallish province defense. At least, let's see if my barbarians manage to select a Colossus. Enemy units, I think they have, so that was worth it. We lost that battle against Agartha, it was this one here, but we killed two, we killed several enemy units, which is nice. A battle at Mountains of Madness. I think this is a big battle against against the throne of Agartha. Let's watch it. Following my infantry, my heavy cavalry. That's what we should do, because that's what takes the units that will take the enemy commanders, and with it the will to fight for their soldiers. So we won this battle. How were the losses? Amazing. Well, we are under a lot of pressure in many places, but this I'm very glad. This army just took solely one loss, one Surf Warrior, our lousy troops, and managed to kill all of these guys fairly easy. We won the Throne Province. Let's see. I'm going to see how can we to keep control of that province. Less 2 Dominion, plus 3 slots, and less 5 Province Defense in that unexpected event. I could really use another treasure. And we lost a scout he was in a big party, in a 241 units party of Ctis. So we lost a scout, and we have people starving, and one filthy brigand was killed by patrolling. Around here we are under a lot of pressure, but Van Dijm cannot move really much further than they are without going through these two castles, and even if they have one big, or at least one nice army, it won't be able to siege and conquer easily these two provinces. So at least these two castles will stop them. Around here we have here my prophet, and we have here both my two armies around here. Let's see where I can send them. We have here a juicy target, of course, another throne. What does this throne do? Increases death, claims, spreads dominion, plus 1 death for dominion, 1 earth gem per turn, and you can get the Mage of Autumn. Not especially good combination that we don't already have in our dwarves, so but okay, it's a throne. And I think that's it. Nothing special around here. Well, my friends, give me a moment and I will issue the orders for the next turn. So, let's start with the recruitment. Capital. 3 healthy drinks and a lot of Youthcarls. Over here, more Youthcarls. And right over here, more Youthcarls. That's the recruitment for this turn. Let me just double check. Yeah, I haven't spent money in commanders. Spent a couple of points around here just in province defense. My prophet army is going to move over here, and he will be joined by why not Lightning Bolt. This guy is going to be to join our armies and cast spells. Okay, and you are fine over there. So he will join over there and will help out with a couple of lightning bolts. This army is going to move right here. So let's disrupt a lot Agartha Agartha lands, and this army again is going to move over here and disrupt one Agartha province. So that's our main goals, and this would be we would be in heaven if we would only be worried about this and not being attacked elsewhere, because clearly we are doing fine. And if we could send a couple of these armies to mop up, it would clearly be a very good battle for us. But what makes things interesting, it's like this. So we are in one side, we are attacking against Agartha, and the other side we are barely defending against Van Nyn. So that's it. I have from my capital an army moving out. It's going to move here and then probably around here. I don't know if I'm going to get attacked around here or not. So he'll move here and then around here, because these two fortifications allow me to have a buffer of a couple of turns. So I will move my army here. I can show you the composition. Not a big army, but a respectable one, because we have our fabulous heavy cavalry. So that's it. And I have, of course, a couple of units spread around, site searching. One thing that I forgot was we found in the midst of all these battles, we found two magical sites. Let's see. We found over here two magical sites. One Wolf Oak gives one nature, and one Endless Forest that gives one nature and one astral. Really, really good find for a level one nature mage, because we already have plus three. We now have plus three nature gems, and can be helpful in powering one of these guys to level two nature if we don't find any kind of alternative to start forging some items to our commanders. And I think that's it. It was just one thing that I had remembered that I forgot to speak, and now I have. Let's check magic. We will get alteration level 3, then evocation level 4, and enchantment level 4. The level 4 now with this kind of research are fairly quick to reach, so let's get this out of the way. Evocation level 4 gives us Thunderstrike, Bolt of One Life, a couple of items that spells that we can, if we need, we can cast, even Blade Wing to our dwarfs. So it's nice to have that option. And after that, we'll get enchantment level 4, which also is quick, and this one gives Raise Dead a nice spell to spam skeletons in battle. So let's get these spells available to us. Even Cloud Trapeze, it's a nice spell, so that if we need to move our commanders quickly, Cloud Trapeze is going to be a quick way to move around our casters, our mages. So that's it. Even that setup of magic, it's going to be fairly quick to reach. So I need to add extra research magic path. So we are ready. Before finishing up, we are ready to show you nation overview and finish up the turn. I'm going to use my revenant with the school staff to get another revenant, and my revenants are going to take over in this kind of stuff. So I'll get a couple or five or six revenants. Some of them will be forging school staffs, and others will be researching. So it's going to be our base research mage, much more effective than the ones that we get by default. Let's finish up the turn. 11 commanders. Yeah, I haven't moved almost all of my scouts. Let me just check. 1, 2. Well, you are hiding. No, you should not be hiding. You should be searching for magical sites. Yeah. As you can see, the wonderful thing of always showing the nation overview, the nation overview before finishing up the turn. It's clearly a nice combination. With, of course, the warning of commanders doing nothing. Three scouts doing nothing. You are also doing nothing, so You can research. Well, this turn I forgot. Even forgotten a couple of things. You are hiding. Yeah. I have set up the option, I can show you. Preferences. There is around here one option. I don't know where it is that says when we recruit a commander, they will by default be researching. So I am used to being all of the units being being researching, but these two that were not were the ones that I moved from this province around here. So that's why they were hiding instead of researching. But there is an option around there that you can set it to auto research after recruiting. So that's it. Let me see if I forget anything else. Hiding, researching. Yeah, all okay. You are defending, but correctly. You cannot do nothing because if I make him patrol, he will get slaughtered by attacking by the attacks from Vanheim. You are sneaking. Move, hide. Yeah, just scouts. Now we are ready to finish up the turn. 8 scouts are fairly well on where they are. So let's check out what's going to happen this turn. Well, lots of battles. My god. So, some kind of information. Okay, first off, battle between... Let's see our first battles, check the final ones. We attacked a guard at Leash. Let's see the battle. Should be fairly straightforward. Okay, we're reaching their commanders. And what it's great, and for instance in my Plagger campaign I do not have, since I have this big cavalry, they almost clear up all the stragglers that flee the battlefield. So we do a very good job cleaning up after winning the battle. If it was a battle where we were playing Plagger, half of the army of the enemy army would flee successfully, and we will have to fight it again next time. And with this, we will see. Probably no one escaped alive from this battlefield. Let's check this first battle. Yeah, 27. Came 27 were died. Are dead. We just lost 2 Ascals. Second battle, we were attacked by Agartha at Tifalia. Just small province defense, so we shouldn't have that many defenses against us. If we manage to kill a couple, I'm satisfied with that. We lost that one, nothing special. We managed to kill 3 enemy units. We were attacked at New Spring by Vanheim. Of course, and we don't have any kind of defense, just a couple of barbarians. They also have barbarians. And they have their mounted herdmen. And we lost this battle. We killed 4 barbarians and 1 mounted herdman. Next battle. Here we attacked. We were attacked by Agartha at Mirene. Let's see. These guys, just heavy infantry, against our. Let's see if we manage. Yeah, I think we managed to dish. No, we did not. I was being happy, but I'm not. we'll probably lose this province. And now we attack that Assyria. Let's see. Yeah, this one should be fairly easy. It's done, Assyria. No losses, which is great. And we attacked at Tenera, one of their thrones. Kelly Dreams smash around and we managed to kill all of the province defense and no losses for ourselves. A battle at Ironwood Forest from Vanheim. We should lose this fairly easy. And the battle between Ctesh and Vanheim and Ctesh one of our former provinces, Lydia. Unexpected event, plus 20 province income. We are under siege and patrolling. We killed a couple of units. So let's take a quick look around. Nothing to worry about, nothing special. Okay. But lots of stuff to do. Now these guys that are sieging my castle, that's nice. That's really nice. These guys that are sieging my castle, they don't have anywhere to flee. Because Ctesh just managed to conquer their escape path. So they got also this province here. Clearly, I don't know why Vanheim were so eager to attack us while they were being attacked by Ctesh. But okay, so lots of battles raging all over the place. At least for now, and let me knock on the wood. We are not getting attacked from the southern side, which is very helpful. There's here a big army from Agartha, but I'm not too worried about it. Okay. That's nice. I think, yeah. Well, lots of information to digest, my friends. Lot of information to digest, and this is going to be a good spot to finish up this episode. Well, if you like wars, if you like lots of things happening at the same time, you are clearly at home, because we are having a tremendous amount of battles in this Let's Play. Even with these lots of battles, I hope you are enjoying this Let's Play with Helheim, and I hope to see you all in the next episode. Until then, thank you.